So it's the last day at IBC and it's a little bit slow, which is really nice for us exhibitors. So I went over to the Fieldcast booth and I have Theo with me. He'll show you how their fiber system can move an Ethernet signal to and from the camera, which is really useful if you want your robotic cameras cabled with fiber and connected to a Skahoy controller.
I will try and show you in a very short time the basic way we think you can use fiber to go longer distance from the controllers of Skahoy or any other controllers, but in this case, of course, the Skahoy controllers, to control a pan-tilt zoom camera at the complete other end of the complete chain. So let's go to the first box that we are using for that. That's our, as we call it, our fiber station, which is here. At the front you see a Ethernet connector, and the Ethernet connector is of course for the controller to plug into. At the other side, this is the more important part of it. At the back side you see that we get the power from a simple mains cable to the box, but the box gets that AC power into the SMPTE cable. And this SMPTE cable is the best cable to go from A to B over a long distance and at the other end have enough power to continue doing wonderful things. So let's go to the other end. And then we land at the backside of the second box, which we call the fiber node. And the fiber node gets the power from the SDI, the SMPTE cable. So the whole box runs on the power that comes from the other box. So we have loads of power available here to do the next things. And let's go to the front of the box, and then you will see that this box resembles the fiber base. It has Ethernet connection at the front also. And the controller, as you see it here, is running on the box. The monitors that you see here are also running on the box, so it's completely powered from the OBFan fiber base.
So this is really a remote node we have right here.
Yes, it's a remote node, and the remoteness is real remoteness because the SMPTE cable makes it possible to go maybe a kilometer or further from the fiber base from the OBFan position.
Wow.
Now, the good thing about the way we configure it is we think that from this point on we can go, and we go to the backside again, we can go DC with our flexible and thin cable and our small form factor hybrid connectors. So here we go 36 volt DC and have the last 100 meters or maybe 200 meters to our box that can do the conversion from fiber to SDI and the conversion from fiber to Ethernet. And now you have seen the whole chain. This is a Marshall PTC camera, which can be controlled over Ethernet. So it can be controlled by the Skahoy box. This camera runs on this box, also the power. This box runs on the fiber node, also the power. And this box, as we already explained, runs on the power from the power base. So the whole chain from power base to camera is running the power from the power base. And I think this is the best solution we can think of to have SMPTE cable for the big distance and much power, and at the end our thin Fieldcast cable to go to the small camera.